What a wonderful position to be in, to work with up and coming dogs and new generations. The clients put so much time and effort, expense, heartache, joy into working with these dogs and training them to a very, very high standard. Everybody's got to start somewhere. I've definitely seen an improvement with Ian over the 3 years that he's been following us and he's been on Patreon. It was a pleasure to meet him at Alan Chadwick's for the first time. It was very, very novicey and he really needed guidance. He then came down here, used the rabbit pen, got some tuition, got some constructive criticism, but he came back. He came back because he wants more. We've had our ups, we've had our downs. We've had our agreements, we've had our disagreements. But overall, it was a wonderful few days that he spent with us. It was a pleasure to see his wonderful dogs and the commitment that he's got to get these dogs right. And as a trainer, it's my job to be honest and open. And when I put up videos, I don't put up videos to show people up. I put up videos to help people and help others. Without people like Ian willing for you to see his videos, his good parts and the parts that he needs to work on, then this group wouldn't be the group it is. Without people like Ian in the group who get involved, who are willing to have criticism in public and yet move forward and achieve a very good standard of training with their dogs that so many people would be proud of and jealous of getting them to a good standard. It's easy to get the first 50% right. The more perfection you want, the more difficult it becomes. The finer detail, the timing, the polish is the added things that unless you're with the right trainer who knows what he's doing, you won't get there. It's as simple as that. We all think our dogs are wonderful. We all think our dogs are the best. Sometimes when you're good to see a trainer, you get a reality check. But I'd take any of these little dogs home. But one stole my heart. One stood out. And it wasn't, I would say, the best dog, because you've got two young dogs and the sky's the limit. We don't know what they're going to be like. Depends how they turn out in the long run. But I like the one with spirit. I like the crazy one. But then again, I sometimes like crazy people. Characters. Every one of these pictures were completely different. Completely different. But they've all got their little quirky sides, the little bits that you make you smile, make you come away with a smile on your face. And that's what it did working with these dogs and with Ian. I like it when the handler's happy and the dogs are happy. But life ain't a box of chocolates, as Forrest Gump says. Sometimes you've got to buckle down, put your big girl pants on and get on with it. I want to thank Ian for trusting me, and you've got four beautiful bitches there. Well done, Ian. Hope you enjoy the photos. Like I said before, sometimes it's just good to get out and have fun with your dogs and knock the training on the head. Taking these photos was refreshing. Again, I haven't done it for ages, but it shows the importance of the quality and the memories you can keep forever. Dogs will get older, but you'll never forget these pictures and the memories of training with Chris Upton. I fell in love with a cocker bitch. You'll have to guess which one. That might be a bit of a hint. Thanks, Ian, for bringing your dogs and spending time with Chris and Sue at Corleone Gundogs.